Friends, Tinkercad just added some brand new features that'll speed up your workflow and make Tinkercad faster. I've got the details, so let's get cracking. Friends, this is Tinkercad.com. It runs in a web browser. I always choose sign in with Google. Before we get building, I do want to highlight the resources and I want to highlight the blog. If you move over here, this is where we talk about bundle groups for efficiency, organization, and awesomeness. You can click on these and read through them. There's a video that explains it. If you've used Tinkercad at all and you've ever seen the red lines that you have to wait for, this is what bundle groups solve. In a nutshell, a bundle group is instantaneous. They all stay together, but they are not combined. If you create what's called a union group, these are what we've had before, parts will add and subtract from each other, and there is some time there. This is the bundle group, this is the union group icon. Bundle groups are really slick for SimLab. If you use a bundle group of basic shapes, they make it a more smooth and accurate surface for when working with a SimLab project. This is a fun example of SimLab gears, which always was a problem, and now we're great. If you haven't used SimLab, check out this link up here in the corner. So let's start with create brand new 3D design. All right, so in my design, I'm going to call this bundles. Today, I'm going to just highlight the bundles. I'm going to let you know that if you use these basic shape, bundles are even faster, but we're going to do it with a complex shape. I'm going to type brick. And when you do, you get this awesome brick wall. This is a complex shape. I've got an awesome castle tutorial. I'll put it up here showing you how to do that, but I want to show you this part of it first. I'm going to start by making the world a little larger, so our castle's kind of fun and big. I'm just going to backspace and put a 4, and I'm going to backspace and put a 4. Now when I click out here, we've got a larger world to play with. First, I'm going to show you how this shape takes a moment. I'm going to change the height to 70 and press enter. And notice it compresses as it recalculates. These are user-created shapes, and when you do this, it just takes more time. I'm going to make this a 7 and press enter, so that it ends up being 70 tall. Now these red lines are what it looks like when Tinkercad is thinking. Notice it does take a long time to compute, but that's the beauty of this project. I'm showing you how we can get rid of those by using basic shapes. So here we go making this castle. Control D, shift nudge to move those apart, find the way I want them joined, and then I'm gonna do Control D again and again to make the walls of my castle. I'm gonna call this good, and then I'm gonna select all these. And I'm gonna instantly make them a bundle group. Once again, that is Control B, and they are green. Instant grouping, how cool is that? If we had chosen Control G, there would have been a little bit of pause as they turned into a normal group. I'll show you that again in a minute. All right, so let's use this same brick to make a fun tower on the side. When you bring the brick out, we're gonna change it to one row, and we're gonna change it to one column. I'm going to tell you the height we want is 10. That makes it easy for making the tower. And we're going to make the width 22 and press enter. Note it takes a second for the brick to arrive. Sometimes you also have to type the number again. That one finally snapped when I clicked it, so we're good to go. I'm going to click on this little guy and do Control D. And then I want a 7 centimeter diameter tower. So we're going to shift nudge 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I can now grab those two shapes, and we're going to do Control D. And because of the 360 degrees, we're just going to rotate till these just barely touch. Notice that is 30 degrees. And then if we let go and do Control D again and again, it goes all the way around and they snap together. That is one of the cool things about math, is you can make things look pretty sweet in an instant. So now we're going to select all those 12 shapes, do Control D, and do Control Shift Up. That moves up an entire centimeter. Now we can grab everything, rotate it to about the halfway mark. Notice 15, 17, anywhere is cool. And if you let go and do Control D again and again, you can build your whole tower instantly. I'm going to stop mine at this height. I'll just let you see that it was 9 total. And then here's where it's gonna get cool. I'll show you the difference between a bundle and a group. I'm gonna grab the whole chunk, do Control D, shift nudge to move them apart. When I select this and I make it a bundle, bing, it just happens, it turns green. If I select these and do Control G or the normal union group, check it out, it turns red and there's a pause as we wait for those to actually combine. This is why you bundle instead of group. Does it eventually work? Yeah, but if you have groups and groups and groups of groups, this is what slows Tinkercad down. Now I can move my tower to where I want it, nudge my wall to where I want it, and of course just continue to build my castle. Super slick. Of course, just using duplicate, rotate, and nudge until it looks just the way you want. So real quickly, hopefully you guys all understand this is a shape that was grouped. We used to group these and they became one color, and then all of a sudden everybody was kind of flipping out because they maintained their colors. That was because of the soon to be released bundles. Notice now, if you bring out a couple shapes, I will cruise these on top of each other. Let's add one more funky one up on this work plane. And if I take these and I do the old style Control G or the union group, now you are back to getting that single color everybody wanted. All right, so let's review real quickly. Bundle groups are a newer way to create a set of two or more shapes for easy selection and modification. That's the definition. Things that are benefits. They keep their original geometry even if they overlap with other shapes. Creating a bundle is instantaneous. The shapes default to multicolor and keep shapes' original colors. You can select a bundle by clicking on any shape within it. Shapes that are in a bundle are moved, rotated, and scaled together as a unit. Any shape, including holes, can be part of a bundle. You can create bundles of bundles and ungroup bundles to revert back to separate individual shapes. You can also tell a selection is a bundle by the green outline on the shapes bundle, as well as the title inspector, which reads bundle. And finally, bundle groups can improve simulation results in SimLab. Don't forget, if you want to learn more about SimLab, I've got all my tutorials up here. Of course, union groups are a way to combine two or more shapes together, creating a unique new shape. Solid shapes combine, while whole shapes subtract from that result. Shapes that are union grouped will be combined into a single new shape. Creating a union group will take some time to compute, as overlapping solid geometry will be combined together. And of course, whole shapes will subtract from the resulting shape. Remember, union groups take some time to compute depending on the complexity of the shapes included, and the resulting shape defaults to a single color of the resulting shape. Of course, you can create union groups of union groups or ungroup them to revert them back, but do note that groups of groups slow Tinkercad down. I've got a video about that. Of course, I'll put a link in the corner as well. You can also tell a selection is a union group by the title in the inspector, which reads Union. Friends, of course, make sure you stay tuned. There are other features that were added, and I will be highlighting them tomorrow. Of course, if you come up with good uses for this, please make sure you add them in the comments below. As I wrap up, I want to say thank you to everybody that's supporting me via YouTube memberships. Absolutely love how that group is growing. There are three different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month, and with any level of support, you get early access to videos. A super huge shout out to my Patreon supporters as well. We passed 200 supporters yesterday. That group is absolutely fantastic. There is a messaging board that even free users can use. You really need to check it out. You can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.